Okie dokie, I'm back from my grocery trip to the co-op. The co-op is a place that has local groceries. They're locally sourced for the most part. Of course, some of them are big brand names, but the produce that I bought is all locally sourced. So, anyways. Henrik shared a video with me on Facebook. The 20 strangest vending machines in the world, and challenged me to make a video about strange vending machines that I've seen. I haven't seen too many really strange ones, but I have seen one that dispenses puzzles, like Rubik's Cubes, the Rubik's Star, and all those variations of the Rubik's cube that you can find, including the 6x6 one, which is next to impossible for a human being to do, but some people can do them. I know a person that can solve any puzzle you give him, and I mean quickly. He's literally a super genius, and he's capable of solving literally anything you give him very quickly, even if he's never even seen the puzzle before. So yeah, anyways, beer vending, there's the puzzle one. There's the beer vending machine that I've seen. It has, I think it had nine different kinds of beer. There was one with bathing suits, disposable bathing suits that you could get at a hot springs. I forget which hot springs it was. Was it Radium? I think it was Radium Hot Springs. Anyways, you could get a disposable paper bathing suit out of the vending machine for I think it was $2 at the time. It's probably like $5 or $10 now. But anyways, because that was really a long time ago, like in the 1980s. Those are there was one that dispensed coffee and soup. So you had coffee, just plain coffee. Coffee with sugar, coffee with cream only, coffee with sugar and cream, and three different kinds of soup, all from the same nozzle in the same vending machine, and they all sucked. That was at a school that I attended called SIAST at the time. It had the vending machine in the hallway, and it was, interestingly enough, right in front of my locker. My locker was here, it was there, and right behind my locker. And they had pastry vending machines in there as well. A number of things. They had pickled egg vending machine. It had pickles and pickled eggs. Several kinds of pickles, and I think three different kinds of pickled eggs. Yeah, I'm pretty sure there was three different kinds of pickled eggs. The one that was the most popular, the vending machine only dispensed this product because it was super popular. Now, we had a very rude name for it. We called it dog shit with Smurf cum in the middle. It was a fair-sized pastry, and it had this blue stuff, blue gelatin in the middle, and I have no idea what the blue stuff was because it didn't taste like anything else. It only tasted like it, you know. There was it didn't taste like jam. It didn't taste like a strawberry jam or anything like that. It tasted only like itself. And I have no idea what it was supposed to be because I had never experienced the flavor other than it. But it was really, really good. It was super tasty, and it had frosting on it as well, a drizzle of frosting on top. And they were really good. The vending machine only dispensed those things. So yeah, and then there was Jolt Cola. The original energy drink was Jolt Cola, and they had a vending machine for Jolt Cola. So in the one room there that was a sort of a lounge, it had the vending machines, a myriad of vending machines, including a cigarette vending machine, I might add, at the time. I'm sure they don't have that now, because that's politically incorrect to sell cigarettes now, especially in vending machines, because kids can get at it. Anyways, so yeah, the Jolt Cola, the dog poop one, and yeah, beer, all that stuff. Yeah, those are the only weird ones that I've seen in my life. The puzzle one being the strangest, of course, because it didn't dispense food, it dispensed an object. No, there was a jewelry one that I say I never used it, but I saw it in Calgary. There was a jewelry one where you could buy earrings and necklaces. For $5 a piece. That was in the 90s, of course. But that's an interesting story all to itself, because I went there to meet up with somebody, and I spent 5 days with this guy. And I met him online, and I spent 5 days with this guy, and he fed me gourmet meals and very, very expensive scotch. There was six of us the one night at his place, which I was staying at. There were favors involved. Anyways, but he fed us this gourmet meal, because he was a bona fide, really good cook, right? I mean, he really could cook. But yeah, he fed us this gourmet meal. It was a party for just the bunch of us. And the scotch was a $2,500 bottle of scotch at the time. I cannot remember what it was called, but I do remember that he said it was $2,500. So yeah, he had a lot of money. I wish he would have kept me. It would have been nice to be with a person that rich for the rest of my life. But anyways, he was a nice guy too. But yeah, he just I guess he went through people. Anyways, you don't care. It's sleazy and you don't care. But anyways, that's it. That's all. You have a fabulous day, and keep smiling.